two characters. Godfather 2 was largely an original screenplay. It took some of the historic parts out of the book, but all the modern story was sort of I invented. And then later, Mario came. And again, we always worked together.
I think it's a great collaboration, you know. The funny thing is, in all this, Francis was the literary guy, and I was the practical guy, you know.
In some ways, when you look at part two, you know, you see more of Francis. And he's kind of biographical efforts. I think he took part two more personally than he did part one.
I began to have this crazy idea that we could cast another actor to play Marlon Brando or the Aurora, and of course, I had my eye on De Niro, whom I had met in the casting of the first one. I just kept going out, and I would look at him. In fact, Bobby De Niro noticed. I was always looking at him. And what I was looking at was that, yes, I saw some sort of relevance that he could play, not maybe Marlon Brando as a young man, but he could play Vito Corleone as a young man.
What's my story, Piagetti? Piagetti, non lo scuoto. E spiegaci la mia storia in tasto un vicinato da suo leone.
I do like very much the Nero sequence when he is stalking Fennucci. The Godfather Part 2 had several scenes of violence in it, and I knew that every time you do a murder, you needed a little detail, a little something to set it apart from all the other murders in all the movies. The case of the light bulb, I just thought that since he had loosened the light bulb, Fennucci might be on to the fact that he's about to be ambushed. Those are just directorially the things you do to try to make these moments interesting, especially violence, because violence is such a disgusting thing to watch unless you give it some eccentricity to make it memorable. Probably the smoothest movie I ever worked on. It like was a very big movie. It was involved in five or six locations.
We went out to Tahoe where the whole thing takes place in the compound, and he had all the actors improvise a day on the compound, improvise their characters, just improvise.
I always approach rehearsals for all my film with the roots of the fact that I was originally trained as a theater director, so I always have a period of a few weeks where the actors get together.
And it created an enormous bond amongst us, because we were intimate, we were living together somehow, so all of us became like family, portraying members of a very strange clan.
Michael, you say you love me, and then you talk about allowing me to leave.
There are things that have been going on for years between men and women.
Michael, you're blind. You've become blind,
Michael.
Look what's happened to us, Mike.
You sense the decline in Michael and in everybody around.
Say it over. You're nothing to me now. You're not a brother. You're not a friend. I don't want to know you or what you do.
Well, the whole story of Fredo was very moving to me. The idea of Fredo ultimately being the traitor.
I knew it was you, Fredo. You broke my heart. You broke my heart.
A sequence I think is beautifully directed is when Michael is sitting in that chair, and the sister comes in and begs Michael to take Fredo back into the family.
Can't you forgive Fredo? He's so sweet and helpless without you.
And then Michael going in and seeing Fredo and embracing him. And in typical Godfather fashion, looking over at Al Neri standing there, knowing that they're writing his death. That's Francis at its most unpredictable and beautiful, really.
That was very strange to Mario, because he had a great difficulty accepting that a man would ever kill his brother.
I didn't want Fredo to be killed, but Francis was adamant, so I said, okay, but You can't kill him until the mother dies. Because I felt that if Michael killed his brother while his mother was still alive, the audience would never forgive him. Whereas they might forgive him if he did it after them.
I chose something from my own life. As a child, I had gone fishing with my family, and I remember this pretty well, that every time I would say a Hail Mary prayer, I would catch a fish.
Every time I put the line in the water, I said a Hail Mary. Every time I said a Hail Mary, I caught a fish.
And no one else on the boat would catch a fish, and I must have caught 20 fish with this technique.
You believe that?
So when I wrote the script, I chose to have Fredo tell the story of the Hail Marys and go out and fish on the moment of death.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners.
And The Godfather, when it came out, received a lot of criticism that it glorified gangsters, it glorified Michael Corleone. When I had the opportunity to make the second film, I thought I would show a man really damning himself and in the end having nothing, just being this lonely guy sitting, you know, with these horrible ghosts in his head. And that last shot of Michael, to me, was the end. And then finally the picture came out and it got not good reviews. But then, little by little, over the months, I've started hearing, no, the second one, you know, I like that even better than the first one. And then, of course, by the end of the year, when it won all these Oscars, I mean, again, I was astonished for a second time on a project that I thought, although it was pleasant to work on, but that I thought people didn't like, and it turned out they liked that one, too.